coming by in the pre-race parade. Cody Chevrolet, the official pace car for 1991. At the Berrytown EMS service. Hope you don't need those folks today. Glad they're here. Blake and Loso with us 31 years. Blake and Loso. And right behind him, the Woodbury Auto Service Facility Tech, in case it's needed. And in a moment, ladies and gentlemen, the winners of last week, Sunday afternoon, of stock car racing will be introduced. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing now the winners of last Sunday's racing program in the third meet of the season at Thunder Road. Let's send each and one of them off with a fine round of applause as they are introduced. First of all, in the new Napa Legend Series, a guy who is really a legend, as you found out if you bought the official souvenir program today, would you welcome the one and thank goodness the only, Donald Dipstick Tiffany, car number 15. Winner in street stock competition 1 week ago. His battle flag flying today, number 48. Would you welcome from Morrisville, Monty LaMare. And ladies and gentlemen, the king of the road, last Sunday with a triple crown from the Berry City area. Would you welcome number 27, Greg Blake. Burger Blake. Their battle flags up for this afternoon. The Napa Legends will be in the street stock division. Pretty much stock automobiles with Bill Barkham out of South Burlington on the pole, number 71. Post position number 2 from Washington, Vermont. Number 60, Rosaire Sears, sporting new colors this year. In the third starting position from Montpelier is Doug Murphy at number 80. And starting fourth will be Les Abbey from Northfield, number 83. Running in the fifth position, number 69. That's Don LaHue from Northfield, number 69, rolling up. Starting in the sixth position would be the car number 38. And the black and gold, number 38, is Claude Cross from Wilson. Starting seventh is Chet DeBarney, number 14, pace car coming in. Going eighth is Jimmy Young from Morrisville, watch the one car. In ninth is Steve Craddock, the 65, Ron Lowell at 87, and Rick Kelly at number 70. Eight laps, first qualifying round, street stock division, sideways out of two. Bill Barkham, number 71, he's your leader. Barkham coming by out in front, 60 in second, Rosaire Sears. On the outside, number 80, rolling, Doug Murphy, whoa, 53, high and wide, laying down a smoke screen, out of turn number 2. Back straight away, down out of 3 and 4. Barkham out in front. Bill Barkham is your leader, number 60, Rosaire Sears working in second. Rosaire Sears, number 60, in the second spot. 69, holding third. John Big Daddy LaHue goes to the inside. On the outside, the 38, coming back. John, number 38, rolls up on the outside. Quad Cross for second position. Quad Cross, roll to 71. Bill Barkham leading 3 laps, now goes down, spinning out. Battle for the lead. Rosaire Sears in the 60. LaHue fighting back in third in the 69. Quad Cross, 38 is your leader. Quad Cross at 38 by short tire length. Quad Cross with 2 laps to go. 38 is your leader. No contest, no contest. Walk over for first. Great battle for second position, 14 on the outside. Chet DeBarney Jr. DeBarney on the outside. 60, Rosaire Sears on the inside. White flag, 1 lap to go. Whaley back up in front. Now here comes Rosiers here in the 60. Whaley back on the inside. Final lap to Varney in position. On the outside, number one, going for it. 69 down low. Right to the finish line. 13 in second. A great run by Claude Cross in number 38, starting in the sixth position and working his way up to the lead on lap number six. Let's have a fine ovation for your winner in round number one, Claude Cross, ladies and gentlemen, from Wilton, up in God's country. On the official finish, in third position, number one, Jimmy Young. Finishing second, number 14, Chet DeVarney of Georgia, Vermont. And completing his lap of honor, let's have a nice round of applause once again for number 38, Claude Cross, your winner. Second qualifying heat on the pole, number 68, from Northfield, Spuds McKenzie. Outside, double zero. Joe Steffen of Essex Junction in row two, number six. Bill Herring starts on the outside of row two with number 51. Burlington Bad Boy Bobby Dragon, and there is a scratch on the field. The number six car not making the post. So it will move up to 51, Dragon for third, and the 77, Frenchie LaFountain from East Perry in fourth. Starting fifth is Dean Gallison out of East Perry, number seven. The sixth position is number 64, Brian Williams, Brian from up in the Wilton area. Starting seventh is the 01, Dave Patton of Hardwick. Going eighth is the 04, that is Miller. And riding shotgun is Skip Patton of Hardwick, Vermont, number 10. Second, eight last week. Spuds McKenzie going to work in the lead. Double zero, Steffen sideways. Bobby Dragon down the inside. Bobby Dragon finds the hole, 77 in trouble, about backing off. Inside 51, up for second spot, double zero. Joe Steffen is in third. Leader coming around is 68, Spuds McKenzie. Dean Gallison taking the high line. Back straightaway, 68, Spuds McKenzie out in front. Dragon, number 51 in second. Double zero, Joe Steffen in third. Out of fourth. To go, 68 stays in front, 64 to the outside. Two laps to go this time around. 64 to the outside, trying to make a run. Here comes Flying Brian on the blue, number 64. Oh, McKenzie sideways. Brian up the outside. Brian Williams going for the lead. Number 64, Brian Williams on the high side. Spuds McKenzie down low. Bobby Dragon back. White flag, one to go. Timeout at 64 in front, 68 is in second, 51 is in third in the back straightaway. Bobby Dragon pulls up on the outside, 68 on the bottom. Here they come for the finish. 64 will win it. It's 68 in second. Wow. Great move from seventh position, Brian Williams, as McKenzie got in trouble, took the outside shot out of the Widowmaker. And let's hear it for this kid that just gets better and better from Wilkett, your winner, number 64. Let him hear it. Tell him you love him, Brian Williams. Nice run. On the official finish, in third spot, number 51, Bobby Dragon from Burlington, Vermont. In the second position from Northfield, Spuds McKenzie. And completing his victory lap, ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it once more for Brian Williams. Very fine qualifying round. 64, your winner. Ladies and gentlemen, third qualifying round, eight laps. Number 25, Steve Copping, will be on the pole. Number 19, Jerry Humiston is scheduled for second. Number 36, Ricky Roberts of Graniteville will go third. Starting fourth will be Mark Barnier, number zero, coming by for fourth. Starting fifth will be Brent Currier, number 30. In the sixth position, from Randolph, number 85, Cal Poulin. Going seventh, number 74, Charlie Benoit out of North Ferrisburg. Then comes the 02, Ted Clark, followed by Sean McFarlane and Rick Dennis of Colchester. At the line, they're underway, and they're already at it. They didn't even wait and be polite. They mixed it up before they came to the line. Good battle up in front. 25 is your leader. 25 is your leader. Five car dice for the lead. Out of Graniteville from the point, stays in front, 30 down to the inside. Brent Currier takes one, takes two. Currier on the move. Currier up to third from fifth. Up to 30, Currier. Goes looking for Ricky Roberts. The point man, Steve Coffey, staying out in front. Currier closing ground, good race. Back on the inside. Currier worrying number 36, Ricky Roberts, to the outside for the lead. Roberts sideways in three, sideways in four. Turn one, it's still Copping. 25 is the leader. 74 goes downstairs. Charlie Benoit finds a hole. Here comes Currier back on the inside. Number 74, Roberts moving up. All right, full contact in turn two. Currier in number 30, bombarding, barreling down the inside. He's into second. 30 is now your second place car. Two-lap indicator on the field. Two to go. Two to go. Lap and a half to go. 25 is your leader. 30 closing. Copping out in front. 30 moving up. Here they come. White flag. One to go. In turn one. Copping out in front. Currier's going to go for it. Currier in number 30 pulls up on the outside. Currier dives back to the bottom. Here they come out of four. The winner flies the flag. Copping in 25. And on the official finish, in third position, number 36, Ricky Roberts. Finishing in second position, car number 30, from Johnson, Vermont, Brent Currier. And your winner, returning the checkers now. Once again, put your hands together for number 25, Steve Copping. Copping, your winner. Qualifying heat now coming on the speedway. At number 54 for this eight-lap event will be Steve Lovely. Starting second, number 78, Dan Lowell of Wilcott starts outside of the front row. Row two will be Terry Reel of Barry, number 11. And flanking him is number 26, Brendan Moore. Starting in the fifth position will be number 48, last week's main event winner, Monty LaMare. Watch him. And beside him comes Mike Rivers of Essex Junction, number 47. Then comes Ralph Rockwell in the 81, and they're ready to take three. 09, out back is Reg Staley in the 03. Roy Morrison, they're at it quick. Field coming down out of three. As they wheel around into the main straightaway, the leader is car number 54. 54, Steve Lovely out in front. Lovely in the 54 has the lead, 11 going downstairs. Terry Reel for second spot. Terry Reel in the 11 pulls it up. Down they come at 54, your leader, Lovely. Reel in second, 78. right there, Don Lowell. And on the inside, the 11 finds the hole. Real at number 11 going through, and Monty LeMaire with him, slamming himself out of turn number 4. Hole contact. Wow, 09 in trouble, flat tire. Right front down on Rich Daly from Plainfield. 48, Monty LeMaire, high side, going for it. LeMaire looking for first. Out of turn 2, number 11 on the inside, 48 on the outside. It's Monty LeMaire, rim riding, trying to pull it up. Here he comes in 4, down the main straightaway. Still side by side. 11, Rio won't let go. Great race for the lead. 11 and 48, wheel to wheel, 3 straight left. 11 and 48 back into turn 1. It's Real on the inside. Monty LeMaire on the outside pulling up. It's Ralph Rockwell in third in the 47 and 4. Coming around. White flag. One lap to go. Final time around. 11 trying to hold on. Can Real stay there? Now on the outside, LeMaire drops back. LeMaire makes one more run. Rockwell in the 81 pulls up. 47 down. Winner at the line is number 11. Some wild racing in the fourth round. And your winner, who really had to struggle for it, started in third and fought with Monty LeMaire for 4 laps out of the 8-lap distance. So as he comes by, ladies and gentlemen, let's have a nice round of applause for car number 11 from Barry, Terry Real. Real, your winner. On the official finish, in the third finishing spot, we have a dead heat on second spot between the 81 of Ralph Rockwell and the 48 of Monty LeMaire. And again, ladies and gentlemen, your winner coming by, Terry Real, with a well-deserved win. Terry Real. And let's turn you over to your regular announcer now, Dave Moody, as we escalate the speed by some 15 miles an hour a lap and bring on the famed Thunder Road Flying Tigers for their first event of the day.
Thank you, Ken. Hello, everybody. Just off the boat from Ontario. What a ride. Pepsi Flying Tigers are ready to roll. Heat number 1 of the afternoon. The 44, Dean Kennedy, will be your pole sitter. Outside, pole the 07, Dennis Carrick. Row 2, Storman Norman Andrews in car number 2, the 16 of Kip Stockwell. Steve Miller, the 00, the 80 is Mike Knapp. The number 15, Joey LeCaire, Gary Cowan in the 22, and Tony Andrews out back in car number 20. Tiger time at the road. Here they come to the line. The green flag is out. 07, Dennis Cowan on the outside break leads it. Stockwell, 16, high side going for second, right behind the 80 of Michael Knapp. Outside line getting the break in for. Norman Norman goes to the number 4 spot right behind. Here comes Stevie Miller. The 00 beginning to move. Andrews in the 2. The 00, Steve Miller. High side, turn number 2, Storman Norman begins to move now. Here comes the 2 on the outside, challenging Knapp for third. Norm Andrews gets it all the way to the wall on the front straightaway. Leader Karen sideways, and here comes Stockwell. Inside line now gets the break. Kip Stockwell to the lead. Knapp in the 80, right behind him, and Steve Miller. Kip Stockwell, the 1990 Rookie of the Year, on top now. Mike Knapp, the 80, down to the low side for second. 00 Miller, the 07 Karen loses it for. Gary Cowan with a handful of race car. The 07 all over the track as he is back to the number 5 spot. Norm Andrews now will start it over. High Rockwell trying to hold on to it. Mike Knapp in the 80 is even in three. White flag is coming out. It's a drag race. Kip Stockwell, Mike Knapp, side by side in one. Stockwell is sideways. Knapp on the outside. Halfway there. White flag is coming out. Checkered flag is out. Here they come. Down to the line. It's going to be Kip Stockwell. As the Tigers kick it off this afternoon for Cody Chevrolet. Kip Stockwell in the 16 with some great driving to hold off the pack. Fourth spot to Storm and Norman Andrews in the 2. Steve Miller, the 00, is third. The 80, Mike Knapp is second. And how about it for Kip Stockwell, ladies and gentlemen? They threw everything at that kid at the kitchen sink, but he had him covered high and low. Stockwell letting it all hang out. The 1990 Thunder Road Flying Tiger Rookie of the Year gets the job done in heat number one. Ladies and gentlemen, from Randolph for Stockwell's Garage, Buick Kip Stockwell, your winner. Heat number 2 rolling out. Pole position, the 31, Lance Furneaux. Outside of Furneaux, the number 97 from Jericho, Dave Gibbs in the AMC Concord. The 57, Jim Barton goes inside. Row number 2 on the outside, the Alan Clark machine. Car number 12 for Bobby McCaskill. Mark Lanfield, the number 42 from Morrisville, will start fifth. Outside, the 29, Brent Wheeler from Waterbury. The 68, Jim Silly, the Times Argus machine. The 93 from Barry is Brian Kilburn, riding shotgun Roy Turner in count number 30. Heat number 2 for the Pepsi Flying Tigers. 10 laps the distance. Down to the line they come. Green flag is out. Furneaux, 31, down to the line, leaves it off the inside, right behind the 57 of Jimmy Barton. Barton on the low groove, 42, Mark Lanfear, McCaskill, Silly, Wheeler as Dave Gibbs is off the pace. The 97 in trouble at the top of 4. Keep an eye on the 68, Jim Silly is ready to go to work. The Times Argus machine begins to ramble on the outside for 4th place. McCaskill down low in the Chrysler. Silly up high in the Oldsmobile with the brake. Jim Silly down the back chute, trying to gather it up. Back comes Bobby McCaskill. Great race for the number 4 spot. Wheeler sideways at the top looking for room. Jim Silly goes to the number 4 position. At the front of the pack, the 31, Lance Furneaux. Furneaux out on top. The 57, Jimmy Barton is second. 42, Lanfear, and here comes Jimmy Silly. The man on the move is 68, Silly. He goes to the outside. He wants third spot now for Mark Lanfear. Jim Silly rim rides up to the wall in 4. Jim Silly, once again from the back of the pack to challenge, loses ground on the outside. Lanfear in the 42, 68, Jim Silly going at it for the number 3 position. Jim Silly gathers it up one more time, beginning to move on the 42 of Lanfear. Laps are winding down. 5 down, 5 to go for Lance Furneaux, looking for his first career Flying Tiger checkers. Furneaux has led all the way in this one. Barton is second, 42 Lanfear, the 68, Silly then Brett Wheeler. Jim Barton, who took the checkered flag last night at Airborne, holding on to second. Look out, Brian Coburn doing a little agricultural racing. Checkers are out, and it's Lance Furneaux winning it. Jimmy Barton, 10th, second, third to Mark Williams here. Jim Shilley and Brett Wheeler, the top five finishers. So Jim Barton in the 57, who picked up the checkered flag last night in Plattsburgh, New York, able to do no better than second here this afternoon. Ladies and gentlemen, first-time winner on the Tiger Tour. How about a round of applause for Lance Furnow? Well, I understand I missed the excitement. I'm told that Rupert Irwin renewed his nickname once again. I was probably about Altona, New York when that happened. A great ride for this young man from Williamstown. He struggled getting this car dialed in, but he's got it on a rail this afternoon. Heat number two, ladies and gentlemen, Lance Furnow, the 31-year winner. To the number 23, Mike Potter in the Pontiac. Potter, your pole sitter. Outside the number 85 machine, Mike Pelkey. Pelkey in the Ghostland Granite Dodge Aries exploded a motor last week here, has got it back together. Third post position, the number one, Boss Hogg, Red Mead in the Ford Thunderbird. Outside, Mead from Mooresville, the 75 of Defecto. The Kentucky Colonel, Tom Tiller, in car number 55, will go fifth. Outside, last week's Triple Crown winner, Berger Blake, in car number 27. The 35, Jim Gallison Jr., and on the outside to ride, shotgun, the number 14 from Mooresville, Phil Scott. Burlington. Cody Chevrolet pace car jumps in, and we're set to go. Pepsi Flying Tigers ready to square off at heat number three. Mike Potter, Mike Pelkey, nose to nose, and Juan Green is out. Side by side, all the way through one and two, down to back shoot. Whoa, Billy! Pelkey almost hits for the ticket booth. Gets the 85 back on. At 23, Michael Potter shows the way. 75, Pete Becto is second. Berger Blake up to third and looking for more on the inside. The 27 is taking it out. Mike Potter stands side by side for the number two spot. 27, Berger Blake. 75, Peter Becto, then Pelkey and the Kentucky Colonel. Pull himself into it. Here comes the Colonel on the outside. The 23, Mike Potter. Becto going high, second place now to Berger Blake. Blake in the 27 has the runner-up spot. 75, Becto is third. Pelkey in the 85 and the 55, Tom Tiller. Cars shuffle at the front. Berger Blake wants a piece of the action on the outside. Blake on the high groove, beginning to reel it in now. 23, Potter. 27, Blake. Becto in the 75, beginning to shake it down for the lead. Here comes the Berger up on the outside. Potter trying to hold him off. Berger Blake with a nose up now. Blake in the 27, your new leader. Final time, down the back straightaway. Potter back to the inside. Berger Blake shuts him down. Play four. Potter six. Defecto. Tom Tiller on Mike Pelkey. Third spot to the 75. Defecto from Mooresville. Mike Potter with a strong run to the runner-up position. But ladies and gentlemen, this fellow's on a hot streak. He is now 4-for-4 over the last 2 weeks. Berger Blake, the 27, your winner. Spotted, ladies and gentlemen, the 27 gets it done again. Berger Blake from Bell, your winner. number four for the Tigers. Fourth and final qualifying round for the Pepsi Flying Tigers rolling out. The number 13, Richard Bootsy, will start on the point in the J&A Buick. Outside Bootsy, the number 25, from Essex Junction, Dave Woodgood. Big Bigelow in the number four machine will start next in line. Outside Bigelow, the 83, from Mary Ryan Denville. Pat Corbett in the blue and pink, number five. Joe Skip takes over on the back straightaway. Ryan Denville, the 83, around the outside to second, and here comes Dwayne Lanphier. Lanphier, the defending Flying Tiger International champion, up to the third spot. Down to the low side. Ryan Campbell, 83, looking for room. Couldn't find the room to race it. Pat Corbett working the outside of the five. He wants a piece of the fourth spot. 25, Dave Whitcomb is your leader. The 83, Ryan Campbell second. Lanphier, the 40, is third. Corbett now fourth, followed by Big Bigelow. And Richard Lucy drops back to the field. Lockdown tangling on the first two. Vroom goes all the way around, refires, and will continue on. Field stays green, the challenge for the lead. Ryan Campbell beginning to turn it up. 25, Dave Winchell, the 83, Campbell. Here comes Lanphier. Lanphier trying to do it on the low side. Can't find room in four. Running nose to tail with 25, David Winchell, 83, Brian Campbell, Dwayne Lanphier in the 40, and Pat Corbett beginning to gain on the lead draft now. Corbett in the 5, beginning to make some progress out of the back of the pack. Two laps to go this time for David Winchell. The turbo blue machine on the point with two to go. White flag will fly this time, and it's Dwayne Lanphier looking to the outside in four. White flag, one to go now. Single file out of two. Final time down the back two. Dave Whitcomb, a 25, leads them. Checkered flag coming out. Whitcomb will win heat number four. Brian Campbell is second. Dwayne Lanphier third. Fourth to Pat Corbett, and Big Bigelow comes through testing car number four. So Davey Whitcomb takes the outside pole start, parlays it into a wire-to-wire victory. Heat number four, ladies and gentlemen, the Turbo Blue Buick. From Essex Junction, Dave Whitcomb, your winner. Pat Corbett. And the number five machine finishes up in the fourth spot. Dwayne Lanphier, the 40, takes third. Brian Campbell with a solid run the second. And one more time, ladies and gentlemen, returning the colors, Dave Whitcomb. All right, tighten up your chin straps, the Crunch Bunch. Semi-feature, ready to shake, rattle, and roll. On the point, all there. This has got to be some kind of mistake. They put Spuds McKenzie on the pole for the semi. The Spudster from Northfield will roll off the inside point. The 25, Steve Copping, will start second. Row two on the inside, Ricky Roberts in the 36 machine. Car number 11, Terry Reel, will go for it. The Burlington Bad Boy, Bobby Dragon in the 51. The 30, Brent Currier from Johnson. The Enduro Warrior, Monty LeMaire. The 38, Quad Cross. Chet Devaney in the 14. The 64, Flying Brian Williams. Jimmy Young in the 1, and out back, Rapid Ralph Rockwell as we get a 3. The dropping second. Oh, Brent Sawyer fights his way down low for third. Ricky Roberts in trouble with 36, takes it off the speedway. Wild Wally in the Spudsmobile is the leader. 25, topping second. Brent Sawyer, the 38, on top, and Brian Bryant. Bobby Dragon pops the cork. Sounds like the right front tire said goodnight on the Dragon wagon. Brent Curia, the 30, going to work for second place. Caution flag is out. Yellow! Look at this. How far can they go before they figure out the yellow flag? Look at them go. They're having a wonderful time. Now they've got it. Wild Wally now has his handicap position. That's a one lap down. The 25 topping. Courier in the 30. Quad Cross and Flying Ryan. Nope. Look out. The Gerber baby just gave Jimmy Undershot. Come on, Wally, catch up, son. Keep an eye on the 68, because he's PO'd now. He was winning a minute ago. And now he's gotten the short end of it. Green flag is out of their way. Brent Currier in the 30, leading on the 25. Sparks flying on the back chute. Three wide. Oh, no. Quad Cross thinks better of it. And Brent Currier on the outside takes over. Brent Currier, the 30, takes the lead. And here comes Flying Bryant. 64, Brian Williams. Jimmy Young in the 1. The Enduro Warrior is the Gerber baby. In the 30 is your leader. Flying Bryant second, and here comes Jimmy Young. Jimmy Young in the number 1, all the way to the wall in 4. Side by side battle for the number 2 spot. Flying Bryant on the inside. Jimmy Young on the outside. Look out, they're leaving it. It's Jimmy Young in the line. Wanted the low groove so bad he took it before it was there and almost got himself crossed up. Courier in the 30. Young in the 1. Flying Bryant. Quad Cross and the Warrior. Good rod of a semi for the Crunch Bunch. Third spot, 64. Flying Bryant Williams. Jimmy Young in the all-seen fine car number 1 gets the number 2 spot. And ladies and gentlemen, semi-feature winner for the Crunch Bunch, the Country Home Center, car number 30, Brent Currier from Johnson. Flag as he wins the semi for the street stocks this afternoon on Cody Chevrolet Day. And now, semi-feature time for the Pepsi Flying Tigers. This ought to be a dandy. Lance Furnell, the 31, draws the point for the semi this afternoon. The 23, Mike Potter, will show second. Dave Wickham, the 25, goes third. 57, Jim Martin in the fourth spot. Kip Stockwell will start fifth in car number 16. Sixth to the 75, Peter Benko. Brian Campbell, the 83, seventh. And riding shotgun, 00, Stevie Miller. And Dwayne Lanfear. Can't believe things are that congested on pit road. Although those fourth qualifying heat drivers haven't had a whole lot. Pace car is in, we're set to do it. Lance Berno in the 31. The 23, Mikey Potter. Dave Whitcomb, Jim Barton, Kip Stockwell, and Pete Becto as we set for green. Down to the line they come, looking for a start. Green flag out of their way. Whoa! Berno gets into the side of Potter. And the 31 drives away with the lead. second spot in the 31. The 25, Dave Winship. 75, Dave Winship and Tim Stockwell. Mark Lamphere pitting the number 42 car. Lamphere is in trouble. As they sort it out in 3 and 4. Mike Potter beginning to pull away now. Second, but 25, Dave Winship going to work. 75, Fecto. 16, Stockwell. Look out, they're off the back chute again. Winship has the whole shot, and he'll take over second. Lance Burnell is in trouble. The 31 machine takes it back. Burnell out of second place retires the car. Mike Potter now. The 23 machine out in front with a healthy lead. The 25 Winship all alone in second. Third spot, the 16 of Kent Stockwell. 75, Pete Fecto, 473, Ryan Tanville. Pete Fecto a little bit crossed up coming out of two, and Ryan Tanville goes for the high groove. Leaning on each other. Oh, man, hold on to your hats. The gloves are off on the back straightaway. Campbell on the outside. Fecto on the inside. Way high goes Ryan Campbell. Both cars turn track at through one and two. Stacked up behind the metal for four. 75 Fecto. 83 Campbell goes. Gets up in the marbles and goes all the way to the back. Less than five laps to go, and Mike Potter's on a cakewalk. The 23 all alone at the front. 25, Winship second. 16, Stockwell third, and here comes the burger. Burger Blake out of the back of the pack once again, beginning to work the outside. Blake in the 27 wants a piece of the number four spot. To go this time. Two to go for the 23, Mike Potter. Winship second. Stockwell and Burger Blake. He's got white flag as well. Burger Blake has got the third spot. Oh, he and Stockwell get together. Great piece of driving. Checkered flag is out. Semi-feature goes to the 23, Mike Potter. Dave Winship, 25 to second. Burger Blake, Tim Stockwell, and the 80 is Michael Mann. Great drive in the Tiger semi as Burger Blake and Kip Stockwell put on the wire to wire for the DJS Transport. Car number 23, Mike Potter, your winner. How's that, Roy? Okay. Raffle tickets. We are over $500 already. How about it for Mike Potter, ladies and gentlemen, returning to checkerboard. Semi-winner. 50-50. We are over $500 and counting. They are on sale right now behind the tower, just a dollar a pop. Don't wait till the last minute. Come see Kate right now. Get your 50-50 tickets. Pepsi Flying Tigers coming onto the speedway. The 1990 Street Stock Champion draws the pole, Tony Andrews, in the Jason's dry cleaning car. Outside, the number 12 for Williamstown, Bobby McCaskill. Bill Scott in car number 14, the 09 of Mark Muller. Joey LeCaire in the 15 Ford Thunderbird. The 93 is Brian Coburn. Red Mead, Econ number one. But 22 is Gary Karen. Jim Gallison Jr., Econ number 35. The 44 is Dean Kennedy. Dave Gibbs in the 97. The 13, Richard Lucy, 94 is Guy Brown. Pace car is in. We're set to go. Andrews on the inside. McCaskill on the outside as the two street stock graduates get set to square it off. Tony Andrews away with it. Bill Scott, the 14, in second. Joey LeCaire in third. Tony the Tiger at the front of the pack. He's gone of a 20. Andrews pulling away. Bill Scott, the 14, in second. And Joey LeCaire, only three will qualify. Three to qualify. Joey LeCaire, the 15, is the man on the bubble. The 09, Mark Marsh, needs to make the ground in turn four. Down the back straightaway, Tony Andrews with the field in hand. John number 20, your leader. Bill Scott, second. Look down, Bobby McCaskill around in four. Chrysler New Yorker back to under power. Field stays green on the back two. Andrews now beginning to pull away. Five car lengths in hand. The 15, Joey LeCaire, is the man on the hot seat. Top three qualify at LeClaire. In the third spot. Richard Bootsy having trouble on the 13. We've got a caution flag on the speedway. That low groove may be able to slide underneath to pick up the top three position. Slow pace through three and four. Here they come. Andrews inside. Scott outside. Green is out. Good jump in the high groove by Phil Scott, but Tony Andrews drives away. LeCaire goes to second. Scott now third. Whoa! Look out, Nelly! Everybody's in it. Four cars escape. Richard Bootsy torn up on the right front. Dean Kennedy with a bloody nose. Jim Gallison Jr. didn't get a piece of it, but he got off the track avoiding it. The 09, Mark Marsh. Red Mead in the one. Bobby McCaskill's out there somewhere. Here comes McCaskill through the haze. Here comes the 22 of Karen, and I think the 93, Brian Coburn's over the top. There he is. Mark Marsh trying to thread the needle underneath Phil Scott. Scott shut the door and Mark took it around. Here they come. In three and four, squared up, ready for a restart. Andrews inside. Scott on the outside for green. Side by side, battle for second. It's LeCaire down low. Here comes David Gibbs trying to steal the final spot away. The 14, Phil Scott holds onto it. Scott in the 14, the man on the bubble now. 97, Dave Gibbs is fourth. Jim Gallison Jr., the 35, is fifth, but only three will transfer. Three-car breakaway. Andrews, LeCaire, and Scott looking to get qualified. Russian flag on the speedway. Red Mead in the 1 and the 35, Jim Gallison Jr. getting together. Andrews on the inside, LeCare on the outside, then Phil Scott, Jim Gallison Jr. Here they come. Green flag is out and they're racing. Andrews again away with the lead. LeCare second, Scott third, side by side, Red Mead, Jim Gallison Jr. with Richard Bootsy in hot pursuit looking for a hole. Tony Andrews leads them down the back chute one more time. And again, it's a three-car breakaway. If they can stay green, Andrews, LeCare, and Scott will be the transfer automobiles. Two to go for Tony the Tiger. Looking for his first ever Flying Tiger checkered flag here at Thunder Road. White flag will come out this time. Tony Andrews is on his way in car number 20. White flag is out. Final time down the back chute. 14, Phil Scott in third. Joey LeCare second. Checkered flag is out. Tony Andrews, your winner. There you go. How do you like that? The defending street stock champion from a year ago gets his first Flying Tiger checkers at the nation's side of excitement. And perhaps even more important than that for Tony Andrews, he's got himself a spot in the Cody Chevrolet Trophy Dash. Phil Scott qualifies for 14 in third. Joey LeCare, runner-up finish in the number 15 for second. And ladies and gentlemen, how about it? He's carried the checkers before, but never in a Tiger. Tony Andrews, car number 20, your winner.
Check. Pick your lane. One, two.
Tony the Tiger with the checkerboard qualifies for the Cody Chevrolet main event this afternoon, and the 20 gets his position. One. That's it. They're out. Steve Lovely, the 54, will be on the point. The 00, Joe Steffen. Car number 78 is Don Lowell. Outside row 2, the 36 of Ricky Roberts. Terry Reel in car number 11, the 68. Well, it says Spuds McKenzie, and he's supposed to start up in front, but he's out and back, so I think it's Wild Wally. The 25, Steve Copping, inherits the 6th position. Ramblin', Rosier, Sear in the Deathmobile. Car number 60. The 19, Jerry Humiston. The Burlington bad boy, Bobby Dragon, in car number 51. The 69, Big Daddy, and his racing caddy, Don LeHue from Northfield. The 77 is Frenchie LaFountain. Brent Currier from Johnson in the number 30. The 38, Ford Thunderbird Cross. The 85, Cal Ford. Mike Rivers, in car number 77. The 14, Philly Baby, Chet DeVerney. The 64, Flying Brian Williams. Charge in Charlie Benoit in the 74. Ralph Rockwell in car number 81. The one is Jimmy Young. Monty Lemaire, the Enduro Warrior, next in line in the 48. Then Wild Wally Renfrew in the Spudsmobile. The 87 machine is Ron Lowell. Car number 2, Bruce DeSomblo. The number 7, Dizzy Dean Gallison. And running shotgun, Rick Dennis in car number 32. Rapid Ralph Rockwell, the 81, finished first last night at Airborne. He's way out in back here. Well, they're racing already, so you might as well throw the... Nope. Uh-oh, this is going to hurt. Hold on. Oh, man, this is fun. Look at them. They haven't learned a thing. They're racing again on the back chute. John's getting mad, I can tell. He had a long night, and he's not going to play with the crunch punch. How the hell with it? Steve Lovely, 54, is your leader. Joe Steffen looking to give him a whack, and does in the 00. Don Lowell, 78, and Ricky Roberts. 36 goes to fourth. Right behind comes the Deathmobile. Rosair, see him at 60. I see virtually no way that this could continue for more than another couple of laps. They are really whacking each other in the back of the field. Steve Lovely leads it. The 11, Terry Real. 78, Don Lowell and Ricky Roberts. Keep it all three wide on the back chute. Look out, Irene. This could be painful. Look out. Oh, oh no, 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 no. Look out, Mama. Oh, no, no. Oh, my heart, my heart. Hey, Bubby was on the way, though. He was going to save the pace car. The Cody family just went right over backwards. They saw that tire heading for their pace car, and they said, oh, this was not in the plan. Oh, Lordy. Brian Bryan's a little bit upset. He's going to go have a... No, he's going to rescue his wheels, what he's doing. Ricky Roberts is back underway. 36 is going to the pits. Oh, man, what a mess. I think the Gerber baby got whacked around a little. Actually, I think he got whacked around a lot. Oh, my. Well, you've got a feeling that when the fourth place car spins on the second lap of a 26 car feature, nothing good is going to happen. Pace car is going to head for safety. He's had enough close calls in this one. And we are set for a restart. Steve Lovely and Terry Real off the point. Terry Real in the 11 takes silver. Three wide on the back chute. Three wide on the back chute, and it's the Burlington Bad Boy up in no man's land. Hold on, Mama! Ow! I don't know how they made it. I don't know why they made it. All I know is they made it. And Terry Real is out in front. Whoa! Claude Claus gets a helping hand. Come on, Claude, don't give up. Not aggressive enough. Not aggressive enough. He's going to go pick off a cameraman. Three wide in four another time. Look out, Jerry Umistetto! Uh-oh! Steve Lovely blew it up. The Lovely Lovers are destitute. Look out, Jerry Umiston's off the track again. The 19 having a wonderful time. Ricky Roberts has looped it in one. Field stays green. Terry Real all by himself in the 11. Rosair Sear with the Deathmobile is second. Big Daddy and the racing caddy is up to third place. Brent Currier in the 30. The 47, Mike Lewis. 85, Cal Puller on the move. Car number 11, Terry Real, way out in front of the pack. The battle now is for third. Mike Rivers, 47, going to work on the outside. Rivers, rim rides to the number three spot. 47, Rivers. The 30, Brent Currier. And here comes Monty LeMay with a 48 beginning to roll now. Mike Rivers on the outside going out to the Deathmobile. Rivers with a nose in front. He goes to second place. Mike Rivers takes over second. Rosair Steele, the 60, in third. Brent Currier, the 30, in fourth. And Big Daddy in the 69. Terry Real is all by himself, but the lap car, oh, there goes the Bad Boy. Bobby Dragon's having a terrible day. Terry Real puts a lap on Don Lowell. Terry Real puts a lap on Joe Steffen. On the outside, Brent Currier, the 30, takes over third place. Currier moving up now. Lap traffic holding up the leader, and here comes Mike Rivers. The 47 is closing in turn three. Oh, down to the inside. but the battle is for the lead. The 11 of Terry Real, 47 Mikey Rivers. Two-car battle out of four with four laps remaining. Rivers looking to the outside, trying to steal it. Mike Rivers on the outside wants it. Real down low, Rivers up high, side by side for the checkered flag with three to go now. Mike Rivers, 47, wheels up in a high groove. Look out, Bobby Dragon! Rivers in the 47 takes it over. Rivers, your leader. Mike Rivers takes over the top spot. Terry Real is second. 48, Monty LeMaire now third, followed by Brent Currier. Oh, look out on the front chute. Look out, they're piled up. Yellow, yellow, yellow flag. But Terry Real will... No. Now tell me how far ahead the leaders were looking. The top two cars come from a lap and a half away and loop it. Yellow flag has been out for 8 minutes. They come out of four and say, oh my God. I love the crunch. Kelly and Bruce DeSomblo. Remember when we started 26 cars? 15 are left. And we still got racing. Here they come. Down to the line. Yes, green flag is out. Mike Rivers, 47. Monty LeMaire, 48. Whoa! Look out, Jerry, come on back. Jerry Humiston, there goes Ricky Roberts. Oh, man, they've done it again. Jerry Humiston just peeking up over the top of turn two. Humiston goes a lap down. Jimmy Young goes down pit road at about 112 miles an hour, and we've got yellow. Yellow flag. Oh, the Warriors in the fence. Jerry Humiston taking a rather quaint little peek over the top in turn number two. And again. Maybe not. That little dink. Jimmy Young, he comes out at about half the speed he went in, but he's running again. Green, white, and checkered for the crunch bunch. Here we go! 47 Rivers. The 30, Brent Currier. Monty LeMaire in the 48, going back for second place. The Enduro Warrior on the inside takes over. White flag is out. One to go. Here comes Monty LeMaire. Final time down the backstretch. Here comes the Warrior. Monty LeMaire trying to pick it up. He's not going to do it. Mike Rivers wins it in the 47. Oh, LeMaire into the fence is second. Brent Currier, Bruce DeSomblo, Cal Poulin, and Chet Devaney, the top six finishers.
Recheck, 1-2.
Ladies and gentlemen, your winner coming down to accept the checkered flag. Let's hear it for Mike Rivers at number 47. Rivers, your winner. Brent Currier, number 30. For third place, number 48, LeMaire for second. Dave Moody will join them down there. Don't forget, Dave Moody's program tomorrow night, 6 o'clock on AM 550 WDEV, and next Thursday night, the first full night of racing, big special event, the International Series, with all the best Flying Tigers from New York State and Quebec here to challenge the best of Thunder Road. Now, down to Dave Moody with your winners.
They've scunned the Warrior. Monty LeMaire's number 48 has been scunned, and I think I just found his nitrous bottle. No, I'm sorry, not a nitrous bottle. Third spot, ladies and gentlemen, for the Crunch Bunch, and a great run it was. Brent Currier, car number 30 from Johnson, gets the number 3 trophy this afternoon, and a hat from Cody Chevrolet. Nice run. A little bit wild out there today, as usual.
Yeah, it was crazy out there, but I liked it.
Mike had it hooked up pretty well. Whoever started outside him was going to lose a spot almost sure on those restarts.
Yeah, he was running good. You can't take nothing away from him. He he had it all the way.
Happy with third then?
Oh, yeah. I'd like to thank all my sponsors, my pit crew. They've helped me all year long. They've gotten me out of some binds. I really appreciate it.
How about it for Brent Currier, the number 30, gets the third place trophy today. Well, the Warrior, they peeled his car like a banana, but he'll take the number 2 trophy. Monty LeMaire, ladies and gentlemen, for second. Warrior, we got to stop meeting like this every single week down here.
Oh, come on. I like it.
I thought you might. Good show.
Thank you.
Car's hooking up. You're running well at Airborne. You're running well here. You have to make any changes on this car, or is she just hooking up all the time?
I left my same tires that I had on last night over here, and I was loose. Couldn't even hang on to it. I went to last week's tires, which were bald. I come back out, and it handled like a dream.
Well, they're still bald. That right rear is beginning to scream right about now. That's when they run good, though.
That seems to be. I'm going to stick with it, I think, here.
Let's hear it for the Warrior, ladies and gentlemen. Monty LeMaire from Morrisville, 48. And how about this guy? This guy came out of the back like a rocket ship. Mike Rivers, the 47, gets the feature win today. Michael, congratulations. The Cody Chevrolet Trophy. That was fun.
Well, it was real exciting. The track was pretty greasy this afternoon during the heat. And the boys were telling me after the concert, real slippery. We did a couple adjustments on the car. And I got hit during the course of the race in the right front, and it stuck like glue ever since.
Got to hit it more often.
Somebody's got to hit that hard right before I go out, I guess, or hit me.
Great job. Congratulations.
Thank you.
That's Mike Rivers, the 47. How do you do, Holly? Okay? All right. The missus approves. He can keep the trophy. How about it one more time, ladies and gentlemen? Brent Currier, Monty LeMaire, and Mike Rivers, the 47. Your top three for the Crunch Bunch. Ladies and gentlemen, we are going to take a very brief intermission at this time, give you an opportunity to stop. Good afternoon, the Cody Chevrolet Trophy Dash down trackside to greet the drivers and wish them luck on their way. Frank Fortin, president of the Corvette Club of Vermont and the service manager for Cody Chevrolet on the Barry Montpelier Road, Dennis Baudouin. Ready to go on the point this afternoon, driving car number 31. From Williamstown, the Arlington Enterprises, Buick Somerset, Lance Furno, car number 31. On the outside point, driving car number 07. From Colchester, the Karen's Auto Body, Chevrolet Celebrity, Dennis Karen. Row 2 on the inside, always one of the very tough competitors here at Thunder Road, driving the Turbo Blue, car number 25. From Essex Junction, Dave Whitcomb. Outside Whitcomb, one of the strong team cars out of the J&A Enterprises Racing Sable. Car number 57 from Williston, Jimmy Barton in a Buick Regal. Inside of row number 3 comes the Poulos Insurance, car number 4. From St. Johnsbury, Vermont, Big Bigelow. And outside Bigelow, he's carried the checkered flag already this afternoon. Driving car number 23, the SNL Auto Supply, Pontiac Phoenix from Plainfield, Mike Potter. Row 4, starting 7th this afternoon, the Ghost Lance Granite. Car number 85 from Barry, Vermont, Mike Pelkey. And outside Pelkey to start in the number 8 position this afternoon, the Kingsbury, car number 2. From Warren, Vermont, here's Storman, Norman Andrews. Row number 5 on the inside to last year's Flying Tiger Rookie of the Year here at Thunder Road. The Stockwell's Garage, Gates Salvage, car number 16, Kip Stockwell. And outside Stockwell, feature winner already in 1991, driving car number 75, the Riverview Garage, Buick Pete Fecto from Morrisville. Row number 6 on the inside, the Maple Avenue Deli Mart, EJ's Auto Body, car number 83, Brian Campbell from Barrie. And outside Campbell, ready to go in the 12th position this afternoon, the 00. From Bristol, Vermont, the Suntan Sands Pontiac 6000, Steve Miller. Row 7 on the inside for that beautiful car number 5, the Bluins paint and floor covering Buick. Car number 5, Pat Corbett of Williamstown, Vermont. And outside Corbett comes the Illers RV Sales, car number 55. From Essex Junction, the Kentucky Colonel Tom Tiller. Next on the starting grid comes the 29 machine, the Vermont Rental Properties, Jerry's Construction, Chevrolet. From Waterbury, Vermont, here's Brett Wheeler. Outside Wheeler comes the Pete's Auto Buick, car number 80. From the capital city, Montpelier, Vermont, Mike Knapp in the number 80 machine. Next, throw back one of the high flyers of 1991 here at Thunder Road. The Times Argus, Darling Trucking, car number 68, Jim Silly from Groton, Vermont. And outside of Silly, ready to go in post position number 18 this afternoon, the Arthur's Department Store Buick from Morrisville, Dwayne Lanphier. Carried his first checkered flag in the Tiger Division early on this afternoon in the non-qualifiers B feature. Starting next in line, the Jason's Dry Cleaning, car number 20, from Warren, Vermont, Tony Andrews. And alongside Andrews, this man is red hot on the Berry High Banks. Triple crown 1 week ago for the Ernie's Garage. Tri-Town Sunoco, car number 27, Burger Blake. And Greg Blake, by virtue of winning the Triple Crown 1 week ago, will receive the $50 bonus from Couillard's Heating Oils of Barry for the Triple Crown, the Heat, the Semi, and the Feature 1 week ago. Starting next in line, post position number 21, the Dubois Construction, Powers Recycling, Ford Thunderbird from Morrisville, Vermont, Phil Scott in car number 14. Alongside Scott, former Flying Tiger champion here at Barry, Vermont. Driving car number 15 from East Montpelier, Joey LeCaire. Starting in our final row this afternoon by virtue of the Thunder Road Flying Tiger Plan 1 option from Morrisville, Vermont, the Lanphier Racing Buick. Car number 42 and Mark Lanphier. And riding shotgun on the field from Williamstown, the Looper Plate, Clark Investment, Chrysler, New Yorker, car number 12, and Bobby McCaskill. Ladies and gentlemen, that is the starting lineup. We ask now that you please rise for the playing of our national anthem. Competition. Stars of the American Canadian Tour return here to Thunder Road, the Pepsi Bicentennial 200, 200 green flag lots for the ACT late models, plus the Tigers and the Streets. Then on Sunday afternoon, the 30th of June, they'll travel north to the Sanair Super Speedway in St. Pete, Quebec. A great doubleheader for area race fans. The Pepsi Bicentennial 200 Saturday night here at Thunder Road. Then on Sunday, June 30th, the Budweiser Triple Crown 150 at Sanair. Main event of the afternoon, the Cody Chevrolet Trophy Dash. Gentlemen, start your engines. Two events still to follow this afternoon. The B feature for the Island Number Street Stocks and, of course, the Napa Legends. Behind the Cody Chevrolet pace car. Lance Berno, the youngster from Williamstown, on the point in car number 31, the 07. Dennis Carrick, the veteran from Williston, on the outside. Then Dave Whitcomb and Jimmy Barton. Big Bigelow and Mike Potter, Mike Belke and Storm and Norman Andrews. car number 57, feature winner last night at Airborne, has the outside row two start as he looks for the twin killing this weekend. Here they come, down to the line. Green flag is out. And the Cody Chevrolet Trophy Dash is underway. 31, Lance Furrow, the 07 Dennis Karen, leading on each other on the back straightaway. Furrow in the 31, Karen sideways in four, gathers it up. Dennis Karen to the lead in the 07. And here comes Jimmy Barton, the 57 with room. Look out! The leader loops it! Oh, my heart! They're all piling it up! Oh, Lord! Cars all over the racetrack! Yellow flag is out! Yellow flag is out! Cars all over the speedway! Berger Blake with a hard hit in the door of the 27 machine. Tony Andrews is in it. The 15, Joey LeCaire. There are cars headed down pit road everywhere. Oh, man, the 07 of Dennis Karen sideways on the front chute. Berger Blake all torn up in the 27, but he's going to drive it away. Unbelievable that that car can even roll. There's nothing left of that machine. Berger Blake has got a spring sitting in the side of the car. The left rear spring on the Berger Blake car is sitting next to the driver in the cockpit. How hard a hit did that young man take? The Phil Scott automobile is up against the wall on the front chute. What a hard break for one of the top snowmobile racers in the country, Phil Scott from Mooresville, qualifying for his first ever Flying Tiger feature, and it lasts about 3 feet after the green flag. Oh, man, and the complexion of this race has changed dramatically. So, ladies and gentlemen, for Phil Scott as they take him out to the garage area. That's a tough break for a young man who very much looked forward to running his first Flying Tiger feature here this afternoon. Dennis Karen coming back on in the 07. The 55 top tiller, Pat Corbett in car number 5, also set to return. Man, oh man, what a nightmare. Jim Barton, car number 57. Looks like he may be looking to take it back to the pit area. Cosmetic damage. Right in the driver's door, literally tore all the sheet metal off that car. Here's Brett Wheeler's car number 29. Wheeler from Waterbury will rejoin, minus most of the front end sheet metal on that car. Wheeler is back in the 29. And it looks like it may be the end of the afternoon for Berger Blake. We've lost 5 cars from the original field, make it 6 as Mark Lanphier pulls in. So 6 cars eliminated before a lap is complete. They'll try it again in 4. Dave Whitcomb now on the outside. Lance Furrow down low. Dave Whitcomb up high on the 25, nose to nose for the lead in 4. Here comes Dwayne Lanphier back. He is a lap down to the field. Lanphier in the 40, one lap down as the 07 gets around again. Dennis Karen having all kinds of difficulties. 25, Dave Whitcomb is your leader as they race the back straightaway. Lance Furrow, the 31, is second on the outside. Here comes Big Bigelow. Bigelow in the 4, holding on to third. Norm Andrews, the 2, is fourth. The 00, Steve Miller. 83, Brian Campbell. Here comes Pete Vecto up the inside of the 75. Great battle going on for the number 3 spot. Give it to Big Bigelow. Bigelow in the number 4, driving around Norm Andrews for third place. Andrews is in trouble. The Kingsbury car is down to the infield and out of it. Norm Andrews pulls it in out of the top 5 positions. Fields sorting it out. 25, Whitcomb your leader. Lance Spurno, the 31, is second. Third to Big Bigelow, the 00. Miller is fourth. Then Brian Campbell, and on the outside, Jim Silly and Mike Knapp going to work. Knapp brushes the wall in the 80. 68, Jim Silly goes to the outside of Peter Fecto. Steve Miller going to the outside of Bigelow for third place on the front two. The man on the move, 00, Steve Miller. 68, Jim Silly, and the 80, Mike Knapp, making ground on the outside. Miller to the high side of the front straightaway, challenging Big Bigelow. Bigelow, the sophomore competitor, has his hand full, but he's holding on to third right now. Miller up the outside, the 00 looking for a third spot. Him a shot from behind going into three. Bigelow holds on to the low groove. Once again, it's Steve Miller going outside. Bigelow, look out, trouble in turn two. 75, Fecto gets in a Mike Knapp and they go around. Wickham, your leader. The 31, Lance Burno, still showing in second. Third spot to the 00, Stevie Miller. Bigelow is fourth, and Jim Silly on the high groove has the fifth spot. 68, Jim Silly cracks the top five in turn four. Halfway down, halfway remaining in the Cody Chevrolet Trophy Dash. Burno, car number 31, keeping the pressure on your leader. Burno all over the back bumper of Dave Whitcomb on the back straightaway. 25, Whitcomb. 31, Burno. The 00, Miller, have broken away from the pack. Lance Burno up to the outside. the 68, Silly holding third. Bigelow in the four is fourth, Brian Campbell, and here comes Tom Tiller. Tiller on the outside for fifth place. Two to go for Steve Miller in the double zero. White flag coming out this time. Miller, your leader. Burrow second. Silly third. Final time down the back straightaway. Steve Miller has it in hand. Checkered flag flies out of turn number four. The double zero. Steve Miller, your winner. Lance Burrow second. Third to Jim Silly, followed by Big Bigelow, Brian Campbell, and Tom Tiller.
Steve Miller, double zero. Victorious again here at Thunder Road on Cody Day. Cody Chevrolet presenting the races today, debuting with the winner in just a moment. A lap of honor on this guy who blew him off from third to first in one series of corners. Taking his lap of honor, Steve Miller, double zero, your winner. From 12th position to win the main event today, Jim Silly with a tremendous run back to third and a great battle at the end. Pulling down, here comes the double zero. Fresh from running in Plattsburgh, New York last night, Jimmy Silly climbing out of the 68 after another great run today. Their crew's coming out to congratulate them. There's more to come, folks. But a great victory for the double zero. Let's go down to Dave Moody, standing by.
All right, thank you, Ken. A wild start and a great finish for the Flying Tigers this afternoon on Cody Day. Let's talk to our third place finisher, the 68, Jim Silly, for third this afternoon. Jim, we got a Cody Chevrolet hat and I believe a trophy for you here as John Casey gets his hands emptied out. You had a pretty good look at that wreck. Everybody did. When the leader goes around, it gets awfully hairy here in the front chute.
Yeah, I was afraid it was going to be the same thing it was last year, but we got the lucky roll this time, got out of it.
Car looked up like it was hooked up pretty good, but Lance Furno's got this thing dialed in now.
Yeah, he's going really good. You know, he's just that now, you can't beat that. You know?
Happy with third then?
Oh, yeah.
All right, how about it, ladies and gentlemen? Jim Silly from Groton, the 68 for third. And here's a nice story. This kid has struggled a bit this year getting the car dialed in, but he had a great run today. Lance Furno, the 31 for second. Lance, congratulations. Super job.
Thanks a lot.
Really came together for you today. When you run the last 10 or 15 laps with Mr. Silly right behind you, earned it.
Yeah, I was watching.
You really had a good look at that wreck. He came right around in front of you on the first lap.
Yeah, I hit him pretty good, but I hit him a good square, so I didn't hurt nothing.
Congratulations. Good job.
Thanks a lot.
Lance Furno, 31 with a runner-up trophy. And the man of the hour, the Suntan Sam's machine, will bask in the sunshine this afternoon. Steve Miller, double zero, your winner. Steven, it looked like to me that the 25 was coming off the pace a little bit there, and nobody wanted to go outside, and finally you just said, to heck with it, I'll give it a shot.
The 25 had a bad push, so the 31 car stayed behind him, and when he did, I went by the both of them.
Just something the veterans know how to do.
After that, it was pretty smooth sailing. I want to thank my sponsors, Barnaby Trucking, Suntan Sam's, and the guys that helped me work on this car, because we had it all apart just before the feature.
No.
A bunch of stuff.
You changed the car right before the feature and ended up winning. That's a pretty good crew, despite what you keep telling me.
Yeah, well, we were just guessing.
That was a good guess. Steve Miller, double zero, ladies and gentlemen. The Cody Chevrolet Trophy, number one this afternoon at Thunder Road. The photographers will get their trophies, and then I believe we've got the B Streets and then the Napa Legends in that order, so I'm going to get out of here because whichever one it is, this is not a good place to be, John. Afternoon. The 0-2 machine is Ted Clark. Mark Barnier in the zero on the outside of row three. The 56, Richard Fleury. Car number 65, Steve Craddock. Francis Miller in the 04. The 84 is Sean McFarland. Car number 09, Reg Daly. Skip Patton in the number 10 machine. The 01, David Patton. And on the backside, the 70 of Rick Gilliland. We've got a couple of scratches here. Either the cars have broken down or they've thought better of bringing them out. We got a few dents too, but a lot of Bill Barkin and Doug Murphy hoping to lap the field so they can get a shot at hitting someone from behind as they go green. Billy Barkin, the 80 Doug Murphy. Oh, look at Mark Barnier, the zero. Mark Barnier beating himself to death in that car trying to get to the front. Whoa, T-bone in four. Yahoo! The number 10 lays a lick on the 84, no problem. At least not from where I sit. The 84 is in the infield. Whoop, the 02 is in the infield. Worst place to be if you're a photographer or a bystander is in the infield. Bill Barkin, 71, your leader. Doug Murphy in the 80. The zero, Mark Barnier. 53, La Savvy, and Brendan Moody in the 26. What color green is that on the 26? I tell you, but this is a family operation. Well, this is about as sedate as it gets with the street stock. Single file racing all the way around the track, but don't worry, they're going to lap cars here in a minute. Mark Barnier in the zero, going to work on Doug Murphy for second place. Murphy in the 80, Barnier in the zero, they're going to go wheel to wheel now. Murphy on the inside, Barnier on the outside. Mark Barnier, feature winner already here in Barry. And they are leaning on each other. Murphy trying to use a little racetrack. Barnier trying to prevent him from using a little racetrack. And Doug Murphy holds on to second. Keep an eye on the white number 02 right in front of the leader. He's going to get entertaining here in a minute, I got a feeling. The 02 is about to have fun here in a minute. He's about to play whack the leader. I've got a, nope, he's going to the pits. Hey, we got a good race going on for second. The 80, Doug Murphy. Mark Barnier in the zero, and Les Abbey getting into it now. The 53 machine wants a piece of the action. Oh! Oh! Doug Murphy roughing up the zero car. You better rough him a little harder, Dougie. Nope, you lost him. Mark Barnier goes to second. But Billy Barkin is all by his lonesome. Bill, slow down, son. Don't hit the wall in the lead. What am I saying? Go ahead. Do whatever you want. Oh! The leader gives a little whack. Look at it push the lap car. He's a half a lap ahead and beating up the last automobiles. 71. Bill Barkin, your leader. Mark Barnier. Uh-oh. The black flag is out. Somebody's going to get it. The 09 with a slightly bent right rear tire. The car was finally beginning to handle and they black flagged him. Bill Barkin is way out in front. 71, all alone with the lead. Mark Barnier, the zero, is second. The 80, Doug Murphy, is third. Les Abbey, the 53, hovering like a vulture over the corpse of Doug Murphy, trying to get the number three spot. So far, Murphy's got him covered. Two laps to go for Wild Bill Barkin. Mark Barnier second, Murphy, Les Abbey, and Brendan Moody. Second place almost took it to the ticket booth. The zero almost had it off the back straightaway. White flag is out. Bill Barkin is home free. The 71 can get out and walk home from here. Checkers are out. Wild Bill Barkin is the winner. Mark Barnier is going to finish second, and Les Abbey, who gets a piece of Doug Murphy, steals third.
One event to follow. Checkered flag is down. One event remaining. Final event of the day coming up. The winners.
I think Doug Murphy's a little hot, Captain.
Bill Barkin from South Burlington. the B Street Stock main event. Pretty good run today. Bill Barkham, your winner. And Dave Moody standing by to present the Cody Chevrolet trophies to the winners here in the B main event for the Street Stock classification.
I think Doug Murphy's a little hot at West Abbey. Shut it off, Mark. If you can. There we go. Oh, go ahead. Wild Bill Barkham. Whoop, I almost got run over by his crew, and they're about to get run over by their own driver. The crew's all down there saying, "We did it, we did it." He said, "The heck with we, I did it." Third place, 53, Les Abbey. How about it? Good job, Les. Car's running pretty good for you.
A little loose.
A little bit loose. Get her tightened up for Thursday night.
Set of new tires. Should be all set.
All right. There's your third place trophy from Cody Chevrolet. A new hat for you. 53, Les Abbey gets third. Beef Beecher for the streets. Mark Barnier in the zero. Come on up here. Another trophy for the zero machine. This is turning into a pretty good season for you so far. Have a hat. Have a trophy from John Casey. Good run.
I always wanted one of these hats.
I thought you were headed for the ticket booth out here toward the end.
I did too. I was right on it. I didn't even let off. I just kept it right warm out. I didn't know how close the guys really were behind me. But I'd like to thank my sponsors, Barnier's Trucking and Marshall Tire, and my crew chief, Kurt and Kelly, and everyone else who gave me a hand.
What's Rivers doing out here?
We live down the street from each other.
You set his car up? No wonder. All right. Mark Barnier, the zero, gets second. And Mr. Barkham, if you please, Wild Bill Barkham in the 71 with the winner's trophy for Cody Chevrolet. Was that as easy as it looked?
No, it was a little harder than I thought it was going to be.
You had pretty much had them in hand today, though.
Well, I wasn't looking. I had no mirrors. I couldn't see behind me, so I don't know where they were.
Where's your mirror?
It's in my other hot rod I totaled.
Well, you'd probably pull it out for Thursday night.
Yes, I will.
Got anybody you want to thank for this?
Yeah, Gordy Pickett, my sponsor on North Pearsburg, and all my mechanics. Aaron, up there in the hill.
Where's Aaron?
Way up in the corner over there.
Yeah, there he is. I can hear him here. All right. How about it, ladies and gentlemen? Great run to the number one trophy for Bill Barkham, car number 71. Mark, watch yourself, because Rivers will want the trophy. As he can't have it.